I guess I would never have imagined that the basic kind of science that we've done for so long would actually lead to a cure for deafness. To think that 3,000 or 4,000 children a year could be treated, it's just extraordinary to me. I never would have dreamed it. We're close to developing therapies for two kinds of hereditary deafness. One of them is called Usher syndrome type 1F. The other one that we work on has the name DFNB1. But we tend to focus on childhood deafnesses, those where the deficit is caused by a mutation in a particular gene. We need to treat them as soon as the deficit is recognized, preferably by age 1 or 2, or the brain will never develop completely. I've been working on trying to understand how these cells work for close to 50 years now. And after working on this for so long, we realized that we had the tools, we had the knowledge. I would say starting 10 years ago that this is something that we knew how to do and we really had an obligation to do. Our research is supported for the most part by the National Institutes of Health. The money is given with the assumption that eventually it's going to lead to something that will help human health. If the funding is cut back by 40 or 50%, there are going to be fewer cures, they're going to take longer to get there. There just won't be the medicines that there might have been otherwise.